It's Eizen the Broniac here. As you can no doubt tell, I did some grinding off level for some gil. Not much to show for it, but at least I got updated on all the spells that I would need and all the equipment. So, at least for that much, I'm doing good. And definitely for some of the items as well. And I wonder, it's kind of sad that I have more elixirs than I do high potions. Take that for as it will. Now, the reason you might be wondering, well, if you're going to continue on to the path, why haven't you healed up already? Well, that's because there's a very good reason. I'm glad I saved beforehand because the first time you go into this inn, rather than paying for a fee, you trigger a cutscene. Even though you still get the sleep theme. And now, here's the cutscene. Which is basically, Galuf can't sleep, so he decides to... can't necessarily say get drunk, but, you know, wet his whistle down at the local pub anyway. And because he couldn't fall asleep too, Butts wakes up, decides to follow Galuf there, and pretty much gets an explanation as to, even though chances are likely that him, Reyna, and Ferris wouldn't be able to return back to their original world, even if there was a possibility, they just decided to go with him anyway because, well, they're Galuf's best friend, and for Butts in general, he just felt like it. Yes, he is Galuf's good friend, and we'll go with there, but otherwise, he just went because he wanted to. Even though he's got his bird pal, Boko, with one of the worst mugshots I've ever seen. And no, I'm still not going to let that go. I'm still going to emphasize it as much as I can. Also, not sure if I said it or not, but just to be safe, welcome back to the Final Fantasy V Forge App Fiesta run. You know, I'm not sure if I said it early on, but you know what? I'm glad I'm doing it anyway. So anyway, we are back here. As you can no doubt tell, I was grinding for some more gil. Got some more stuff out of the way. And even though there really is nothing else left to do here at this town, there's still at least one more thing I want to show off here, which will become evident once I'm able to move. There we go. Is that you're able to grind for gil, not necessarily in battle, but for entertaining people in here, just by dancing. Those are the worst dancing moves I have ever seen. Get off the stage! You're not even a dancer class! Boo! So what's the purpose of dancing? Apparently you entertained people so much, you keep getting 100 gil. And you can keep doing that if you want to. No. No, we're not dancing again. We are all done with dancing. No more dancing. You are neither dancing nor a queen. Got a princess, but that's about it. And I'm failing to remember. Is it this town or the next one that has the organ playing or piano? Said it's in the pub. Oh, you know what? Knowing anything, I bet it's in a private room. No. Fine. Won't do it from there. See that upper corner there? There's definitely a secret there. Here we go. And I know it's not necessary for me since I'm not a bard, nor will I be a bard, but, you know, in the spirit of diabetes, everyone shut the hell up for this piano theme. Getting bitter all the time. I think. No. Anyway, let's move onward with our merry ways and with our quest. And of course, the only other thing I didn't get off screen was white magic spells. There's really no need to do so. Anyway, let's just continue on with auto skill models. And oh no, Butts has been sapped. Whatever shall we do? I actually had the hardest times trying to grind for Gil. Not necessarily with this group of enemies, but those bile, what you call it, where there's five of them in a bunch. Only because they show up so many times and are able to do critical hits multiple times around. Kind of threw me off guard there for a sec, but then I remembered, wait a minute, I have Mystic Knight in my party, so I could just cast Break on my blade and then almost instantly kill them, so there's that. Just a little fun fact, not necessarily need to do right now, but I may as well show it off anyway, so quick save here. See if I can either get to a battle, show off the weapons, or if I'm really lucky, both. So, if we go here, we made it to the sealed room, where we get to see all 12 legendary items. And we can't get until we... The dialogue. Just the dialogue. They're not all stone. I can clearly see color from them. But yeah, here are some of the different weapons that we'll be looking at. Yoichi's bow. Not really necessary because we can't wield it. Masamune. Can't wield it, so don't worry about this. One of the weapons that our Berserker will have, Runax. And since they can't cast spells, what it does, it causes critical damage at the expense of MP. So, if they're berserked, well, what's the point of MP use anyway? So, good weapon there. Holy Lance. We don't have any Dragoons, so don't need to worry about that. Sasuke's Katana, which I think is a ninja-only weapon, so don't need to worry about that. Assassin's Dagger... might be useful if I'm wielding the right class, I think. But next up, Excalibur. I'm not entirely sure if that's a knight-exclusive weapon, or anyone who can wield swords can use that, but if I am able to use that, great weapon. And two items I know I won't be able to use, Gaia Bell and the Apollo's Heart. And I think there are some staffs and rods here, like the Magus Rod and Rune Staff? No, Sage Staff. Okay. Had the right idea, and the last legendary weapon is the Fire Lash. Is it always called the Fire Lash? Maybe I'm just used to Flame Whip. Because, you know, Castlevania and all that sorts. So yeah, already saw the weapons. Let me see if I can purposely get myself in a battle here. There we go. Just so I can have a moment to temporarily put my guy down, because I'll obviously need the controls for this. It's pretty hard, and I just... And yeah. That's not your eyes playing tricks on you. It is able to... It has auto shield, so any weapons that you have with a secondary ability, or spell blade with secondary ability, not gonna work. So, don't even think about doing anything like that. And yeah, I'm most likely gonna get decimated in this battle. I say it beforehand, so I really do not care. I'm just showing it off just to show off, and Reyna was already asleep. Why didn't you put her to sleep? Ow, it tastes like burning. And, just to try and put some effort into this, Gaia's Wrath! Yay, we dealt damage to it. But we still died a terrible, terrible death. Anyway, back to the game! So yeah, don't need to worry about that area for a while. Let's go on our merry way. Don't worry, once I do this run next year, you won't need to worry about any of that sort. So now we come to the next part of the game, which, once I say again, the Moogle Forest. And actually, if memory serves, this is our first time in the Final Fantasy series we actually get to see a Moogle. I think the closest we ever got to a Moogle ever. I'm not counting Hummingway from 4. I want to say the beavers in Final Fantasy 2, aka 2 Japan. So yeah, nothing much we can do here, so let's just continue onward here. Woo! You jumped into a pit, you retard. Got an achievement for it. Okay, in all fairness, it actually said Koopa, which was seeing the Moogle, but that's besides the point, damn it. But anyway, let's continue onward, and for doing 8 damage, doing damage 8 times, didn't really seem to do much of anything. And also, I'm not planning on wasting my magic points here, so why am I bothering? Just auto-attack. Don't want to be caught in a position where I'm just attacking constantly, then for some reason guard. You know, I told him not to do it. Because that frustrates me ever so much. And not this area, but the next area, we'll actually run into our first treasure. So, let's just concentrate on forward. It was actually just before we continue. We'll get some gil and Phoenix down. So with that said, let's just finish off this battle so we can move on. Also, I get the feeling once this battle ends, unless I hit solid ground, I'm not going to be able to restore my HP on battle. But who knows? I'll have to prove myself wrong. Let's see if that's true. And oh my god, actually, that might not be the case, considering the amount of damage Galuf is taking. Not gonna chance it. You're up. And attack. Good for you. And you survived an attack. Good for you! You're finally able to cast death on him. And only then does it work. Also, attack. And back to physical attacks. It would not have killed Galuf, but you know what? If their critical pincer attack can do that much damage, I don't want to risk it. And Galuf got a level up! Huzzah! And, not even a chance for me to try anything. That blood slime looks ridiculous. Just plain ridiculous. Also, you could use it. And hopefully, you can cast death on it. Fool! You foolish fool! Yeah, let's just do a Kira on all you. Probably isn't necessary. I forget, did it always have a sap effect on the blood slime? Down to get to the next one. I don't know, maybe it's because I'm so used to other Final Fantasies, and I'm pretty sure, even past Final Fantasy V games did not pull this stuff, so. Just saying, and you still target butts. I'm just glad that battle is over, because otherwise. Anyway, now I am able to use control of my character. Let's heal up before they get a chance to kill us again. And we should be good for now. So yeah, let's get our first treasure here, which is 4,400 gil. I get the feeling if we went down here, we'll get our next treasure. And you're still attacking us, aren't you? Reyna, you're still attacking butts, aren't you? You fool! Foolish fool! How dare you attack your own comrade in battle! I will not allow this! Just attack the thing. Start attacking the right enemies. I don't want you to attack our own allies unless they are confused. It sounded like I was starting to go somewhere like that. Let me throw. I gotta remind myself, in between this recording and the next, to get more water. So I can rehydrate my throat. So that would be nice. Being able to talk in a crisp, clear motion. Yes, you heard me right. A crisp, clear motion. And really, not even 2 frames in, and you start attacking the next one. You're already gonna attack something that's awake, so what does it matter? Yay! You did nothing to it! Good for you, Reyna! Huge asset to the party! Okay, so you're gonna do a pincer attack. No, you're gonna die! Well, since there's only one enemy left, it doesn't matter if I continue on with this or not. Once I go down here, that should lead us to our next chest. Yes, our next chest. Right here. Phoenix Down. So we have all the treasures, or treasures, that we'll need in this area. This could be problematic. Unless, and unfortunately, you're just gonna kill it. No, it'll kill it for me. Thank you. Way to look out for us there, butts. Be careful, Mr. Moogle. There's a skeleton coming towards you. Whatever shall we do? Let's just stand here. Watch ourselves in this battle. And I know that there's a way for you to kill this the easy way. I'm just gonna try and do this the harder way. And watch our skeleton turns into a Tyrannosaurus Rex! Or at least the remains of a Tyrannosaurus Rex. And that thing's undead, you fool! You're only gonna restore its health with that! Oh, not enough rays. Oh, this sucks. No. Yes, cast all on the one enemy there. It'll definitely do lots of health. Let's see if I can cast Blaze on it. Poison Breath? No! Can you die for me? Thank you. Since it's undead, we can kill it like that. And I get Elixir for my troubles. And yes, that Moogle is afraid of us, but because Reyna has the touch, she is able to communicate with all animals. And I'm not gonna say she's Fluttershy. No. If anyone should get that title, we all know it's Krill. She is rightfully so, Fluttershy, because, yeah, Reyna might have close affections towards cute little animals, but no. So this is pretty much telling you, don't step in the sand areas, just follow this path, and eventually you will come to not just the Moogle Forest, but, as we just came from the Moogle Forest, the Moogle Village, to be precise. Right in there. And remember that area, because otherwise you're going to do some heavy pixel hunting in order to find that area. And considering how closely you can move in this area by centimeters, I'd say, rather than spaces, that's going to be annoying to deal with. Just saying. Also, can I cast it on... No, I can't cast it on... So now, we can't really... No, we can't enter that path again, because we are already outside. Now, of course, there's really nothing else left for us to do, except to go there. But, because I'm crazy, let's get into one battle here. Let's get into... There. There's a reason why they're telling you not to go into that area. Strong enemies reside from there. By strong enemies, I don't think this is it. Doesn't seem like they are that strong. I know there was a different enemy there that was immensely powerful. Let's just attack now. And also, I just realized, those are not cactuses. You are not Cactuar. You're just not the Cactuar. So, stop denying that. Stop trying to take us to the sun. Also, I noticed, does it have a counter beetle effect? Anyone who's watching this battle, hopefully someone else other than Kyrix, not to say I don't want him to watch it, but just so I know someone else is watching this video, could you let me know about that? I would just love to know. Now, I know there is a specific... That's not the specific monster I'm trying to talk about. Also, you don't have the break blade, right? Oh well. But if anything else, at least he died in his sleep. And you're not falling asleep, so we may as well just continue. Is that a counterattack? Yes, it is! Well, at least now I know. I still don't think you're a Cactuar. Just keep that in mind. You are no Cactuar. And also, you just cast it. How could you? How could you? Oh well, if nothing else, I'll be able to do it again. And yay, learn Spellblade 2. Seriously, I know there's a stronger monster here. I know there's a stronger monster. It's gotta be here. Unless I'm thinking of somewhere else in general. Because I know there's, like, one monster in particular that's so strong you have to face here. And that's all I'm trying to get. Just to face that one monster. Anyway, just go against that. Hopefully that did enough damage? No? That just deeply upsets me. Raise him back from the dead. Looks like I killed that thing. Yes. So attack again. There, now it's dead. I know for a fact that there is something else there. Of course, now it's not going to bother showing up because I'm recording. I bet you anything. I'm gonna cut out to this. I'm gonna cut away from this battle. And before I know it, first battle I jump into, it'll automatically show up. You just watch. You just watch, folks. That's gonna happen. I just know for a fact that's how it's gonna work. Because this game and recording of this game hates me so. Also, get out of stuff. So, start Petrifiedness. Ouch. I don't think you get any more painful than that. Also, would you stop targeting him? It's really annoying. Also, I don't have enough for a raise. Well, damn. But I don't want him to be left out of the battle, so I'll just do that. I want him to gain experience. Gil, apparently. Okay, tell you what. I'm gonna use my last tent. I'm gonna give this one more try. On camera. Because I'm confident that monster is there. I just know he is. I know that monster is there. It's like one. There we go. Sandcrawl. Thank you. I'm not going crazy. That's all I wanted to show. Thank you so much for that. Nothing else. That was all I wanted. Just to show off that one monster. And you missed the target. And he still dies. Apparently, it was so much of a shock to him that, he had a heart attack. He probably has one strong attack or some sort. Or maybe it's just because he gives away so much AP. Also, one other thing I should show before cutting away is probably, because I was so eager to show off how to get into battle, the proper way of getting to said area. Starting from here, just go. Hug this wall up to the north, then when you reach this forest, start heading east, north along here, then to the east, hugging this wall, up till you get to this opening. That's pretty much all I was showing. And notice, during that time, never once they get in battle, which is showing that all the, hotspots for battles are in the sand desert. And now it's time for pixel hunting. By pixel hunting, I mean we're already in Moogle Village. Yeah, why not? I'll show this off. And once we get back to the castle, we'll continue on with this. And notice that all the Moogles are afraid of you. All of them are afraid of you. Then at the last moment, that one realized, oh wait, you're the ones who helped me out here. And as a reward, board. He's gonna help us out. How so? Inviting us into his house. So we can have all of its belongings. So what is our reward for saving us, Moogle? Ether. Phoenix down. Which is good, because I used it. 10,000 gil! 1 gil. You son of a bitch. A dancing dagger. And a cottage. So, what's good about the dancing dagger, you might ask? It has, well, obviously, it's a stronger blade. It can't, defend against certain things. So, I'm actually going to put this on Ferris for the time being. It has 4 different effects. Trying to remember what they all were. Sword Dance is obviously, for that same attack, it powers up to, like, 4 times normal and does, like, a critical hit. Or just the same basic amount of damage times 4. There's Jitterbug, which is a drain effect, where it's like one hit, whatever damage it does to the enemy, you restore back via lifelink if you're in a magic gathering. Wonder Waltz, which is basically the same thing, only with MP. And then, I'm trying to remember what that other dance was. It's the confusion one. And yes, I'm gonna cheat by looking at my strategy guide here. I remember them all except for that last one. Sue me. Let's see, where is Dancer? Tempting Tango. Or Temptation Tango. Whatever Tango. That's basically all it is there. Let's see. And pretty much have everything but one item here. So, let's actually finish off this area and then afterwards, we'll call it cuts for then. So let's enter this one. Not that one. I think I was talking about this one. Yeah, this one. Where we see it's a Moogle costume. And of course we try it on, because otherwise, since we notice that people are gonna hate us, otherwise, as humans, so we talk to this one. Who suddenly falls in love with us. Oh, good God. Let us not get involved with, bestiality here. And we please it so much, it wants us to have what's in here. Which is another elven mantle, which is good. Which is good. We need, more guard against that. So, actually, now that that's the case, you can actually keep it. And this time, you get the dancing dagger. Because that was the only reason I didn't want to get rid of main gouge, because it's at least something that can block attacks. Well, now that I have another elven mantle, I don't need to worry about that. For that. I'm just repeating myself today. But yes, the only other thing we don't have another elven mantle for is our berserker, but since he kind of needs to see in order to do damage. And obviously, he's doing a great job otherwise when it comes to accuracy. Even when he can see, that's not really saying much. So basically, we would have had no access to that chest unless we put on the costume. But speaking of, oh, they got rid of that. So I was going to say, there was a way in the original one where you could wear the Moogle costume, and there would always be more costumes. So you could be Infinite Moogle Master! Also, I'm pretty sure, I'm gonna say, close to one of the moments where we actually became a furry of sorts? Because, you know, parading around and... What was that noise? I just heard something unlock. Oh, it's him. Basically, it's saying that he's gonna do all he can to get in contact with, our other Moogle friend. And by other Moogle friend, I mean the Moogle that conveniently lives where, Galuf and his granddaughter Krill live in. And they also have a psychic link between each other. Or at least Krill has a psychic link between them all. And also, stop slowing down, game. Because look at this. All the Moogle can do is say Koopo, and Krill instantly knows what the Moogle's saying. So he knows how to speak Moogles. And dragons. And basically any other creature. Because, you know, they can all communicate telepathically. Which makes you wonder if that statement is true, if the Moogle Mog from 6 was always able to do that. And it kind of makes you wonder if he would have heard many voices speaking at once suddenly go silent after the whole Ray of Judgment that Kefka cast. Or if he could hear that so many times that he got so annoyed by it, he suddenly was like, oh, thank God that noise is gone from my head. So this is the annoying part of this game. You were doing so well to go pixel searching for it, when all you had to do was search for the nose in Moogle Village. And now, all of a sudden, just like that, boom, it's there. How dare you? Just how dare you that it's suddenly like that? But actually, we are going close to 37 minutes here, so actually, yeah, we're going to stop it right here for the time being. So we can leave it on this wondrous Windrake theme, because we only get to hear it so many times. Once we gain access to an airship, yeah, we're never going to hear this again. So we might as well take this time to relish in this while we can. So with that, I thank you for watching this video, and hopefully you've been watching the others. This has been Eizen the Broniac saying, if you like watching this video and want to see more, be sure to like and subscribe to my channel. And I even have some more videos on my Daily Motion channel, which is more than just Let's Plays. It also has Eizen Tries, blind reaction to MLP videos, and so much more to that. But with that said, take care, everyone, and I shall see you all next time.